few sword drills to start out, and then Pat Robinson has a couple of things she wants to share. Faithfulness, and then we're going to do our little activity here. Okay? So, we'll do five of these. Five holds up. This is a little bit harder. Titus 3:8. Go.
Faithful saying in these things I will go that thou affirm. Ultimately that they which have been believed in God might be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable unto man. Know therefore that the Lord thy God, he is God, the faithful God, which keepeth covenant and mercy with them that love him and keep his commandments to 1,000 generations.
Beautiful. Yahweh is so faithful to us, isn't he? That we keep his commandments because we love him. We're faithful to him. Okay, next one. Bible's up. Psalm 101:6. Psalm 101:6. Go.
They might dwell with me, that they scriptures. Did everybody hear that? Okay. Good job, five. All right, Bible's up. Proverbs 28, verse 20. Proverbs 28, 20. Go.
Shall abound with blessings, but he that taketh haste to be rich shall not be innocent.
And I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who hath enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry.
And this little book is full of nothing but promises. So my question to you is, how do we know, or do we really believe that Yahshua is faithful to us? We want to be faithful to him, but do we know he's faithful to us? Do we have any signs? No signs? We do have a sign in Genesis 9:16. And the bow shall be in the cloud, and I will look upon it, and I may remember that everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is upon the earth. That's a promise. So every time you see that rainbow, you can think of, he gave that so we will have faith, that we will know that if we're faithful, he's faithful too. He is even more faithful than us, right? He goes back, and he is faithful that calleth you who also will do it. That's 1 Thessalonians 5:25. So we need to remember that we love him and are faithful to him because he was faithful to us first, right? Okay.
Yes. Oh, you did two birds. Okay. All right, Tia, you're next. Getting harder. Okay.
Matthew 25:21. His Lord said unto him, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord. Matthew 25:21.
Oh, Mom, did you already have it? Oh, she did. Oh, she did. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, you boys were quite as loud. Okay, we'll do another one. Men and women divide, so divide, let's say separate. So it's, see how we can do on this one.
Thank you.
you guys want to come up and help with this one? I'm going to be brave. I'm going to be strong and courageous.
I'm gonna be brave, I'm gonna be strong and courageous. I'm I do not.
We haven't done this one very much. Let's do this one.
Good.
let the righteous fall.
Many mansions.
name that Nathan and I, our family did the other day. So I thought we could teach this. I think they got the words, okay, right?
Thank you. Thank you. for all participating in the singing. We did a whole bunch of new songs that we've never done before, so we're all kind of leery, so thank you for bearing with us and us bearing with you. Okay, Roman has a scripture for the day that he wanted to read.
I'm going to read Psalm 119, verses 9 through 32. How can a young man keep his way pure? By keeping it according to your word. With all my heart I have sought you. Do not let me wander from your commands. Your word I have treasured in my heart, that I may not sin against you. Blessed are you, O Yahweh. Teach me your statutes. With my lips I have told of all the ordinances of your mouth. I have rejoiced in the way of your testimonies, as much as in all riches. I will meditate on your precepts and regard your ways. I shall delight in your statutes. I shall not forget your word. Deal bountifully with your servant, that I may live and keep your word. Open my eyes, that I may behold wonderful things from your law. I am a stranger in the earth. Do not hide your commandments from me. My soul is crushed with longing after your ordinances at all times. You rebuke the arrogant, the cursed, who wander from your commandments. Take away reproach and contempt from me, for I observe your testimonies. Even though princes sit and talk against me, your servant meditates on your statutes. Your testimonies also are my delight. They are my counselors. My soul cleaves to the dust. Revive me according to your word. I have told my ways and you have answered me. Teach me your statutes. Make me understand the way of your precepts, so I will meditate on your wonders. My soul weeps because of grief. Strengthen me according to your word. Remove the false way from me, and graciously grant me your law. I have chosen the faithful way. I have placed your ordinances before me. I cling to your testimonies. O Yahweh, do not put me to shame. I shall run the way of your commandments, for you will enlarge my heart.
Okay. Nobody signed up for an amazing pack, so I'll pull my hand out of the hat. How many of you children have heard about fish that can fly? Oh, wow, it's not going to be any surprise for you. Anyway, there are quite a few species of fish that can fly, but they don't fly like birds. They don't pop out of the water and just go flying away and build nests and lay eggs in them or nothing. They're still fish. They just have longer fins, and on the end of their tail, on the bottom part, you know how their tail comes like this, and it's like a triangle or something? On the bottom part of their tail, it's longer. It's got like a long fin. And so when they swim, they go really fast in the water, and then they start coming out of the water, and then their front fins that put out like wings, and they don't really flap with them. They just glide like a glider, because gliders, they don't flap, they just glide, and birds, they flap to go up. And so they'll put that out, and then that little fin on the back will stay in the water, and it'll help them get speed. And then once they get up in the air and they catch the wind current, then they'll start soaring through the air like just like a bird that sails in the wind currents. And they'll go anywhere up to 500, 600 feet if the air current's right. If the air current is not right, then they'll come out of the water and just go back in. But if the air current's right, they can just glide on top of the water. And sometimes the wind will come up and it'll pick them up and it'll go way, way up in the air, really high. But they don't like to do that because there's the seagulls and these big things that look like pelicans with beaks. And when they see those things in the air, they go, "Ooh, supper!" And then swoop them right out of the air. So they don't like to get too high. All the high flyers get picked off. But down in the water, you have full grown. And so the bigger fish, like tuna and stuff, they'll be like 4 to 6 feet long. They're big fish, and they eat lots of fish to get big. So a lot of times the tuna will swim along to get the flying fish, and the flying fish go, ooh, and they try to swim away, but they can't swim as fast as these big, kind of like a little airplane compared to a jetliner. They go way faster. So they come up and they go to swallowing those little fish, and then they get out of the water and get gliding, and the tuna are like, oh, they just got away from me. And they'll escape. So they don't really fly usually for pleasure. Mostly it's to escape from prey, or escape from whoever's preying on them. So that's one way of a fast escape. But if they fly in the air too high, then they'll get preyed on from above too. So they have to keep that happy medium where they don't get pulled out of the water or snatched out of the air. So.
Well, if they get too high, then they'll prey.
Yeah, I don't know how long they can stay out of the water without breathing. Because, I mean, fish, I don't know. For us, when we swim them underwater, we have to hold our breath. So I don't know if the fish holds its breath or he just breathes nothing. I don't know. But I know when I catch a fish, he goes, he's trying to breathe, but it doesn't. Yeah. But flying fish are probably, you don't see them a lot up here. They like the warmer water, so you'll see, and they're all over in the ocean where the water's warmer, probably from the Oregon coast all the way down to the equator and then below the same latitude, probably the 45th parallel down. You don't usually see them a lot in colder water. So I think it's very unique how Yahweh made this fish able to escape by flying. And they live, when they're little tiny, they'll find like where kelp is floating in the water, and they'll lay their eggs all under that kelp, and then all the little ones will hide under that kelp bed, and that's where the little ones grow and feed and are kind of protected until they go out to the bigger waters where they're more vulnerable and get eaten. So anyway, that's the story of the flying fish.